Today we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Yankees and the Baltimore Orioles. Major League Baseball on the show starts now. Asher Wojciechowski, a hurler from South Carolina, will be the starting pitcher in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, it just goes to show you how tough it is to pitch in today's game. This guy has a career ERA over 5. At times he can be good, and at times he can be really, really bad. It'll be interesting to see which guy shows up in this one here today.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one.
First pitch, 1 o'clock.
The 1-0 home.
2-0.
Our temperature at first pitch and even 70 degrees here this afternoon. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man. And just never could commit to the swing there, but he went around and it's even now at 2-2. Now a swing and a miss on the slider as the leadoff man is set down on strikes to open up the ball game.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at-bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with 3 quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
So here's the veteran Brett Gardner as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. Called strike at the knees, 1-1. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty, hey, you know what, D-Row? This Ed Drummond, he's a good umpire. Fair umpire, good ball and strike umpire. Pretty much straight down the road.
That's all you look for, Dan. Just be consistent. I don't care if you're given 2 to 3 inches off the outside corner, but you can't do it on the inside corner. If you're going to stick to one thing and stay consistent with it, no player will have a gripe with you.
And he's in there easily. It's a stand-up triple.
This is an easy decision for him to try for third because he has the play right in front of him, so he doesn't have to rely on any of his base coaches. Good decision to keep chugging, and he makes it all the way around safely.
So a runner at third here with one gone, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge. He's set and the pitch.
Nope.
Down and away, 1 ball and no strikes. High in the air out towards shallow right. Santander waits on it. He's there to make the catch, and here comes the runner from third as this should get him on the board. The tag, and he is out at the plate. So much for our first run of the ball game. So they're able to get the runner to third in the opening half inning, but can't bring him around. Yankees nothing, Orioles coming to bat. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Jordan Montgomery is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Yanks. What's your take on him, Dan?
Really like this guy. He reminds me a lot of Andy Pettitte, left-hander from the University of South Carolina. Not an overpowering fastball, kind of like Andy Pettitte. Low to mid-90s fastball, good curveball. His secondary pitches he needs to improve on a little bit, but this guy has a bright future. Quality arm from the left side.
Now at the plate, Hanser Alberto. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the pitch. Got him to go up the ladder there for strike one. And And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Two balls and a strike to the Orioles leadoff hitter. Swing here on the fastball, and this will get fouled off to the right side. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him. He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
Here's the shortstop now, Jose Iglesias. As he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. Hard hit ball to second. And that is going to sneak on through into right. It's a one-out single.
That's what you want the guys at the top of the order to do. Set the table for the Monsters, 3-4-5. Nice piece of hitting.
Dan Hunter.
Anthony Santander the next to bat. Lifted in the air out to right. Judge is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down.
Batting fourth, the designated hitter, Renato.
So it's a runner at first with two gone. And digging in next at the plate will be Renato Nunez. From the stretch. I was fighting that swing the whole way, but he went around. It's no balls and a strike. And that finds the target. Nothing in two now. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
He wasn't even close to swinging right there. That was a stone cold take.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Still 1-2. Iglesias is off of first with two away. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Orioles leave one. We are still scoreless. Coming to the plate now, Torres. Lifetime against this particular arm. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to left as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
That is it. The left fielder.
Standing in now, Mike Talkman. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. There's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike. Just got the corner that time with a fastball, strike two. The 1-2. Turned on down the line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Pitch on the way. No outs, nobody on. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
He put up a pretty good battle at the plate right there. They finally get him on a 1-2 pitch, but you can see that he wasn't laying down without a fight. He really made the pitcher earn that strikeout.
At the plate, Gary Sanchez. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number 2. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Outside and low that time. Now it's 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive. That being very aggressive right now.
A swing by Sanchez, and this one soaring out into left field. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Man, they already hit one home run, and I thought they had a second one right there. Not quite enough behind it, though, as it banged off the wall for a double. He's giving up a fair amount of solid contact right now.
Into the box, Mike Ford. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Inside with the breaking ball, 2-0.
When hitters are able to lay off curveballs and get themselves into good counts because of it, you're in pretty big trouble as a pitcher. A lot of guys rely on their opponents offering at that pitch, even when it's not in a good location to hit.
3-0 to him now. From the stretch. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
Batting it. The third baseman.
So digging in now, Gio Urshela. First delivery to him on the way. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. To 1-2 now.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
This is on the ground over to first. To Iglesias for one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play and the inning is over. Yankees are off and running early thanks to the solo home run. On to the bottom of inning number 2. It's now 1-0 New York. Leading off the inning, Chris Davis. And they'll need him to get something going here.
The first baseman, Chris Davis.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Davis who's often called Crush Davis. He was a fifth-round pick during the first-year player draft of 2006.
Hey, nothing has been handed to this guy, drafted in the middle rounds, and he has found his way into big leagues. This has turned out to be a really nice pick.
After falling down 0-2 on the same pitch, don't be shocked if he triples up on it.
Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. And he misses there, 1-2. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Too high, ball three.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
And another foul ball. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
That's a pretty sad attempt at hitting a baseball right there. No doubt he was completely fooled because that was a curveball, and it looked like he was late on a curveball. That tells me he gave up on it right till the very end, and obviously there was nothing he could do at that point.
Austin Hayes the next to bat. As he'll take a breaking ball then off the plate for ball one. Hayes, a native Floridian. This is his second year as a major leaguer. And he fouls this one off. The 1-1 home. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball.
He's going to be thinking about that pitch all night if he doesn't have a big game right here. Pulled his front shoulder and everything went with it.
The next 1-2 pitch. Weak roller right side. And there's out number two. Rio Ruiz to the plate now.
Rio Ruiz.
And now pitch on the way. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Two out, nobody on. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Good time to call the change as he swings and misses for strike two.
You know, from a hitter's perspective, you get pounded in and then he throws a nasty changeup away. Is the mindset to tell yourself that he's going to go in and out all day long, or is he going to double up? That's the cat and mouse we're seeing right now.
3-2, full count. Bases are empty here with two men out. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. The 3-2 one more time. Sliced hard on the ground. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. They still trail 1-0. And that'll bring up Tyler Wade. And he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow.
Tyler.
Here comes the first pitch. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. A ball ball and a strike. Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Smith is there and he makes the catch for the out.
Now battle.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Pitch on the way.
Nope. Ball one.
The 1-0.
That's in. Ball two.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
The 2-0 on the way.
Ball. Three ball.
Brett Gardner waits on deck. From the windup, the 3-0 pitch. 3-1.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH. Bases are empty, one man out. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Digging in to try it again, Brett Gardner. He found his way over to third via a triple in his first at bat. From the belt, the pitch. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. That misses. 1-2. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
Hey, expect a challenge right here. Does not want to run the count full.
Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
I mean, that has to frustrate the guy on the mound right there. You get him down 0-2, no put away pitch, works the count back to neutral, and is able to mix in a base hit. Nice job.
Here's Big Aaron Judge, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 0-for-1 here in the early going. And he falls behind 0-2. Hit in the air to right field. Santander will drift over to his left a few steps as he takes it for the second out. Two men on, two out, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder Gleyber Torres.
And that last at bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter. So I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
1-0 the count. That's wide, 2-0.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Two men are on with two men out. And this is a called strike at the letters. Looked like ball three, but make it 2-1 instead. Hit the other way out toward right field. Chasing after it is Santander. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Yanks strand a pair, but they lead it 1-0. also striding in, Dwight Smith Jr. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three.
Dwight Smith Jr.
Here's the first pitch to him. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone. And that catches the outside edge, one and one.
One ball, one strike.
On the ground to third. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Stepping in, Pedro Severino. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Severino.
Now the pitch.
1-0.
One out, nobody on. Ball two. Hey. 2-0 pitch, and that one's over for a strike.
I know he stole a strike right there, but he better be careful with that curveball. That's coming across and catching a lot of plate. And if he stays back, he's going to drive that thing with some serious authority.
The count now at 2-2. Now here it comes. 3-2.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Now batter, the second baseman, Hunter.
Ready for another Alberto. Chance? Hunter Alberto. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Stretch, here's the pitch. Alberto is usually more of a threat when facing left-handers like this. The right-handers tend to give him a bit more trouble, so we'll see if that trend continues. 1-0 count, here it is.
1-1.
Runner at first here, one man out. And he comes back with a gorgeous slider there for strike two. Still even at 2-2.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
High in the air out to center field. Gardner is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Digging in now, Jose Iglesias. A base hit in his first trip.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
First pitch is a breaking ball, taken down and away for ball one. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning. Because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate. And that usually means damage done.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. One left for the Orioles. It remains 1-0. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the fourth. So striding forward now, Mike Tauchman. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Ball one.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
The 1-1 home is a fastball taken high for a ball. High pop up. There to take it is the sure-handed Iglesias, one away.
Now
that's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop-out. Well-executed pitch there.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Gary Sanchez. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one. That's inside. 2-0.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
Now the 2-0. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. Now here's the pitch. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2. And now pitch on the way. A swing by Sanchez, and this one soaring out into left field. Smith's back to the track as he takes it for out number two.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Stepping into the box, Mike Ford. He drew a walk his first time up. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Fouled away. That smoked, but right into the shift. Iglesias gets down to make the play. Touché, sir. The defense on display on this beautiful diving stop at short. The three of us are back with more following this. Leading off the inning, Anthony Santander, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Anthony Santander.
First pitch of the at-bat. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. And now a curveball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
2-2.
And This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Leading off the inning, your job is to get on base and set the table for the inning. That was a pretty good at bat. Then he pushed the count to 3-2 and made the pitcher work. But I think he'd like to have that 3-2 pitch back. Pretty sure that was ball four he went after.
And here's Renato Nunez. As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. Nunez, a 6'1" right-handed swinger and thrower. He's in his fourth season as a major league player. Into the corner and slicing foul. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Made him look silly with that one.
In tight with the slider, 2-2.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back there, but instead they decided to come in. Make him prove he can adjust before you do.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Oh, and he struck him out as well, so he's carving right through the heart of this lineup as there are two away now.
Certainly not showing any signs of intimidation with these middle of the order guys. That's back-to-back K's, and the 3 and 4 guys are harmlessly back in the dugout.
Here's Chris Davis now. Just gets a piece of it, strike one. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. And this will be fouled away. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
As a hitter, you got to be staunch in your game plan. You know he has a nasty changeup, and you got to fight to make sure it's in the zone. That's a great take right there.
And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. 3 up, 3 down, 3 strikeouts. Not too shabby. The three of us are back after this message and a word from our local stations. Bring in Giovanni Urshela. He'll start off the fifth in this one.
Gio Urshela.
Here's the first pitch to him. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Alberto fields it cleanly. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
The batter number 40.
Now in the box, Tyler Wade.
Tyler Wade.
First pitch on its way. Drops in a strike to start the at bat. Nothing and one. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Swing and a miss, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
Man, this guy's really pitched well so far, attacking the strike zone, and he's really kept these hitters off balance.
One run, 4 hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. And this is swung on and missed, so it's 2 up, 2 down to start the fifth.
Well, he's really locked in at this point in the game on the bump. So far this inning, 4 pitches and 2 outs. Got the first guy on one pitch, then absolutely dominates this at bat with a 3-pitch strikeout.
Stepping in now, DJ LeMahieu, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike.
Hey, that's just a great mix of pitches right there, and that's what this guy's going to do if he's going to keep this team off balance.
1-2 to DJ LeMahieu. Trying to send him packing for the second time.
Two balls, two strikes.
One run, four hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. On the ground to third. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Eight in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Welcome back to Baltimore as we send you down to check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Orioles offense with their manager between innings, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Into the box now, Austin Hayes. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And here's one that misses to the leadoff man in the inning. The number six hitter in the lineup. It's ball one. Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Now the 1-0. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Great situation right here. Leading off the inning, you've got to find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for the first out.
Boy, he's really on a roll in the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
At the plate, Rio Ruiz. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
That counts bad.
Fastball in there for a strike. 92 on the radar gun that time. One and two as he chases the slider.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
Bases are empty, one man out. High and deep to right. A ball that's carrying. And just short of a home run, this ball's off the wall. And he'll reach second now with one away.
So up until this point, they've had to bite and scratch for every single thing. But he puts a good swing on this one and nearly knocks it out of the park. So we'll see if it's contagious and his partner can pick him up right here.
So stepping in, Dwight Smith Jr., as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Here comes the first pitch.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
And a sliding attempt at first, but this sneaks by him, a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
This is their time right here. This starting pitcher has been on point all day. Runs have been at a premium. They have an opportunity to do something special right here.
Pedro Severino digs in at the plate as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Runners are at the corners with one man out. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Maybe a bit of an overthrow there, guys. May have let that front side open up a little early to try to pump up on a fastball and sailed on it.
2-1 now. Takes this the other way to right. And this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner. And the run will come in to score from third as that'll knock things up at one apiece. And he is in there.
Boy, not much you can do with that one from a pitching standpoint. Dero makes a pretty good pitch, and somehow, someway, this guy's able to muscle one in for a base hit.
Yeah, and you know what? Good job by the hitter right there, not trying to do too much. I know he got jam sandwiched right there, but he was able to find some green grass and give himself a chance.
Here comes the Yankee skipper on his way to the mound, and we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart in the fifth with the go-ahead run on base. Didn't work the required five for the win, but he could still be hung for the loss should that run come around to score. Luis Sessa takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. Digging into the batter's box will be Hanser Alberto. Ball one to start the at-bat. Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0. Two and one after the foul ball there. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Pretty good spot to be in as a pitcher right now. You can go for the punch out or try to induce the ground ball to get a double play.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The 2-2 one more time is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Really good pitch right there. So you're moving the ball all around the strike zone. But then what do? You come in. That's a hard pitch for any hitter to do anything with. Just really makes it difficult to get that bat head out.
So now to the plate, Jose Iglesias. Yes, he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. A hit and two tries for him so far. The set and the 1-0.
I don't mind him trying to pitch him backwards right there with those two early count sliders, but now he finds himself in a situation where he's going to have to come fastball.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
Here it is.
3-1 with 2-1, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Gardner's after it. And he brings it down to end the inning as the go-ahead run is left stranded. Orioles settle for one. Five innings complete, all tied at 1-1. Hector Velasquez takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Top half of the sixth about to get started. At the plate, Brett Gardner. He singled his last time up. First pitch on its way. Movement in the Orioles bullpen now as they've got a left-hander up and throwing. Comes back with a fastball up and away that swung on and missed. 0-2. Down the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Now to the plate, Aaron Judge. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. Velasquez, a right-hander who stands an even 6 feet. He's in his third season as a major league player. And 2-0 as this one's taken low.
If you've been paying attention, the guy on the mound does not want to come inside. If I'm at the plate, I'm leaning out over.
The 2-0 on the way. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. Strike 2 as that's taken on the outside part of the plate.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. He'll try it again, 3-2. To right field and deep. Look at this thing go. Into the flag court and gone. A solo home run there for Aaron Judge. And the Yankees take the lead. It's 2-1.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. A hit in two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Swung on and missed that strike two. Yankee shortstop behind in the count, one and two. One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Torres is retired, two down now.
Now batting. Left fielder.
Now at the plate, Mike Tauchman. He was retired after popping out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
Two and oh to the Yankees left fielder.
2-0 to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
The pitch. 3-0 now. The pitch. And he finally gets a sinker over here for a called strike one. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field, and it gives the Yankees a 3-1 lead. We've seen these guys go deep three times so far in this one, guys.
You know, D-Row, looks like the boys are dialing long distance from the batter's box so far.
Yeah, the pitchers aren't fooling anyone today, Dan. Let's see if this trend continues.
And now, Gary Sanchez. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. One for two in the ball game thus far. Oh and one count and the pitch. Outside for a ball, one and one. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. The 1-2. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. Heart of the order, 3, 4, and 5 coming up. It's the Yankees 3 and the Orioles 1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Settling in now, Anthony Santander. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far.
Anthony.
Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. Behind 0-2 now. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
No good.
To the plate now, Renato Nunez. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. 0-for-2 for him to this point. Now the pitch. And this is high, a ball and a strike.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Misses ball two. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. Gardner is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. Standing in, Chris Davis. No hits to this point. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
Someone on this offense needs to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and start the line moving again.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Three up, three down for the Orioles. And it remains a 3-1 ball game. Paul Fry is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 51, Paul Fry.
Next for New York, Mike Ford. He'll match up with a new pitcher to begin their half of the seventh.
Mike Ford.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. The windup and the 0-1.
Oh, up there.
Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. But this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
At the plate, Gio Urshela, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. 0-1 the count. And the pitch. Now a swing and a miss, and things are not looking real promising here. Down 0-2.
Not much you can do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
Can't get him to chase. It's 1-2. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp, and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Into the box now, Tyler Wade. Fouled off. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. Hayes has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Bombers, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Last half of the seventh here, now batting, Austin Hayes. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
And that's in there. Base hit.
Hey, sometimes you just got to tip your cap right there. You execute a nice pitch down in the zone, think you're going to get a ground ball or a swing and a miss, and you find yourself with a man on first. Got to regroup.
Standing in now, Rio Ruiz. As he'll take a look at the pitch too low, it's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. The 1-0. Nobody out, runner on first. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. And he got him.
One of the toughest pitches to hit, the straight changeup, right? El Cambio. Hadn't seen it in that entire at bat. And what happens? Gets the string pulled on him right there. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Your attention, please.
So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen.
That's Richard.
Stepping in now, Dwight Smith Jr. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Two and oh to the Baltimore left fielder.
Well, this is the matchup they wanted, bringing in the reliever, but falling behind 2-0 doesn't exactly help the situation very much.
Runners on first with one down. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he gets the call there, 3-1. Three and two.
I think it's a real possibility that they put that run on first in motion. That would help them stay out of that double play that would end the inning, but that's also kind of risky at the same time.
And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Yeah, that strategy is great when it works, but when it doesn't, it's ugly. And he was here to face one guy, and he couldn't get it done.
In now for the O's, Pedro Severino. First pitch on its way. Sinker to open the AB in there for strike one.
Well, the O's have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now would be a great time for that.
Ball one, well below the zone.
Not a surprise to see that low splitter there. Anything with downward movement like that is going to be at the top of the list in a double play situation.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Oh, on the ground to short. Could this be two? To second for one. Back to first, but it's right by him. Not particularly graceful there, and as a result, he'll be slapped with an E4 on the play. Back to the top of the Oriole lineup now, and stepping in, Hanser Alberto. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Orioles settle for one. Eighth inning coming up. The Yankees lead this one 3-2. Sean Armstrong has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 43, Sean Armstrong.
Next will be the designated hitter, DJ LeMahieu, 0 for 2 with a walk for him so far. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball that time.
Armstrong stands 6'2 and throws from the right side. He was taken in the 18th round back in 2011.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
A ball and a strike. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
The 3-1. And a good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball four now to start the eighth inning.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
Here's Brett Gardner now. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Oh, my. This ball is crushed. Where will this one end up? And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game.
Every run helps late in the game. And with this one on the board, they're now up three and only need six outs to end it. They've got a little room for error, and I'm sure they'd like to add to that even more if they can.
Aaron Judge will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hit hard to short. Right to Iglesias. On to first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out.
Now batting.
Torres will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that misses for ball one. And now a right-hander up and throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. Still only one out in the inning. And here's a fastball that's nowhere near the zone. It's 2-0 now.
Not even close with the 1-0. He needs to get back in the zone, but be careful. Work the quadrants.
Now the 2-0. Hit hard down the right field line, but foul. Yeah. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. There's ball four.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Into the box now, Mike Tauchman. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Here comes the first pitch. On the ground now for Iglesias. This could be two. One there. Back to first. And that was a sparkler. A double play, and the inning is over. Yankees get a couple on the two-run home run. On now to the bottom of inning number eight. It's now 5-2 New York. Chad Green is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 57, Chad Green.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Jose Iglesias. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. He's set. Here it comes. And this is on the outside corner for strike one.
Probably a design take right there. They need base runners, so they're going to make him try to bring the ball in the strike zone.
Sent on the ground out to second. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Infielders are taught from the time they hold the glove that you've got to play the ball and not let the ball play you. You can see here that this one just ate him up and he couldn't recover in time.
Ready once again, Anthony Santander. And he's 0-for in this one, batting out of the three spot. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Green is pretty much a manager's dream coming out of the bullpen. High strikeouts, doesn't walk a lot of batters, usually a recipe for a lot of success.
Oh, that's one of the keys. I think if you were to build the perfect relief pitcher, you'd want a guy that throws a lot of strikes, that minimizes the base on balls, and nobody does it as good as this guy does right now in the game of baseball.
Torres at the bag. On to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Renato Nunez, and they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, and it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
He's set, and the pitch.
Count 1-0.
Ready with the 1-0 pitch.
Aye.
A ball and two strikes now. We're in the eighth inning now of a 5-2 ball game. A splitter, but he started it too low as it bounces up to the plate. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Orioles held in check there. They trail 5-2. Now Now at the plate, Gary Sanchez. He went down on strikes last time up.
The catcher, Gary Sanchez.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one. I got one ball, one strike.
A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
And the pitch on 2-1.
That's ball three.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
The 3-1. Right side, hit hard. Davis has it. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. In now, Mike Ford. 0 for 2 for him to this point. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
Nope, ball one.
Bases are empty, one man out. And he misses again, 2-0. Started to go around, but he's able to check his swing for ball three. He's set. Here's the 3-0. Comes with the fastball, but it's outside for ball four.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
Ready now, Gio Urshela. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. First pitch of the at-bat. Hit high and deep to right center. Hayes is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Now back.
Digging in, Tyler Wade. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Here's the first pitch to him. That just misses off the inside for ball one. Two out with the man at first. Skied into straightaway right. Santander waits on it. And that's the third out. One left for the Yankees. And it remains 5-2. Aroldis Chapman takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Aroldis Chapman.
Chris Davis at the plate now. He'll be the one to greet Chapman, who looks to put an end to this one.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score three runs off a closer like this guy, they've got their work cut out for him.
And he lays off there, 1-0.
Tough spot in the game right here. You have a very close call that doesn't go your way. This is when you have to really regroup as a pitcher and go out there and try to make quality pitches.
This one's a strike. It's 1-1.
One ball, one strike.
Ooh, that was some gas. Triple digits on the radar gun.
Two balls and a strike to the Orioles first baseman. And it's fouled away. The 2-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
From the stretch. Didn't quite catch the zone there. Ball one. Now the 1-0.
Well, that's off the plate.
The last thing you want to do when you've got a three-run lead in the ninth is give the other guys any sense of hope. It's a good time to challenge here on 2-0, especially since there's a good chance he's taking until he gets a strike.
Swung on, missed, 2-1.
I'm interested to watch this next pitch right here. He got a swing on a high fastball. I wonder if he's going to pull the old plesac and climb the ladder.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. One out, nobody on. Hit hard on the ground towards second, and that'll find its way into center field for a one out hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
Stepping up now, Rio Ruiz. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
From the stretch. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1.
Hey, now he's got me confused up here. This is a known sinker baller out on the mound trying to roll a double play, and he throws him a four-seamer.
The 0-1 pitch. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, bang.
Now back.
Into the box. Dwight Smith Jr. A hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Aroldis Chapman, they call him the Cuban missile. Well, he needs to start firing some bullets right here. He's in trouble, but I wouldn't bet against him getting out of this mess.
The 0-1 on its way. And low, it's a ball and a strike.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making it work for this one.
Runners are at first and second with one away. Looked like that one tied him up a bit, a swing and a miss.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Into the box, Pedro Severino, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. One for two in the ball game thus far. The 1-0 home.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down the way or flip something off speed for a strike. You cannot miss over the heart of the plate in these situations. The hitter is on high alert.
The 2-0.
That's ball three.
Well, two on, two outs, and he's got himself in a great hitter's count. He just has to be careful not to get too aggressive. A walk would be good here, too.
He's set. Here's the 3-0. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Wow, how quickly things changed. The possible winning run has gone from in the hole to on deck to at the plate. Things have gotten a lot more interesting here in a hurry.
Ready now for Baltimore, Hanser Alberto. He's looking to deliver here with the bases loaded and two out in the inning. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. And, oh, look inside, but that's ruled a strike. Nothing in one.
That was a pretty good fastball after he walked the hitter previous. There was a little angry on that heater.
Two out, bases loaded. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Baltimore down to their final strike. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
And he might get them all home as this is hit high and deep out to straightaway left. On the run, and he makes the catch just shy of the wall. And with that, this ball game is over.
Man, facing Chapman is not for the faint of heart as he unleashes fireball after fireball. Gets the final out here and another save. What a weapon Chapman is.
5-2 the final today. So the Bronx Bombers rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Luis Sessa takes home the win. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.